For me, reclaiming the internet means elevating the voices of people that are usually left out of conversations that shape the decisions that we make around technology. Then we can improve health for the population at large. My name is Elaine Nsoesie. I am an associate professor of public health at Boston University School of Public Health. My work focuses on using data and technology to advance health equity. So I was born in Cameroon and I spent the first 16 years of my life there. Growing up in Cameroon, I could see the challenges around who could have access to a hospital. And in most cases, you had to have money to be able to go to a hospital. That sparked my interest in public health. During my postdoc, I worked at a lab at Harvard Medical School that was focused on developing digital tools for public health. And I was fascinated by how we were using data and algorithms to develop these tools. But after a while, I began to ask questions about the data. Who is represented in the data and who is not, which led to questions around data bias, algorithmic bias, and eventually to the work that I'm doing now. When we build algorithms that did not take into account the historical context of the data sets that we use, then we're likely to recreate or amplify the biases that are in the data. One algorithm that was developed in the US that was being used in hospitals for patients, but the algorithm assumed that Black Americans did not need as much care as white Americans did, and did not take into account that there are a lot of factors that have kept Black Americans out of the hospital. So I think there's a lot that AI can do in terms of measuring those disparities, but also can be combined with other methods to look at things like policies that have been put in place and how those policies are either changing things or making things worse so that we can correct them. One thing that I've been working on is increasing representations of groups that are underrepresented in the development of AI. And I've been doing this through Data Science Africa, which is a program that is being led by Africans. And the focus is to build data science capacity across the continent.
Can you tell us more about the importance of Data Science Africa?
Yeah, Data Science Africa is an amazing organization that was started in 2015 in response to the need for data science capacity on the continent. We've had about 12 events so far across 8 countries in Africa. We invite researchers working on the continent who are developing solutions to African problems to come and share their research and interact with others in the community and build a network to support each other. Being a Mozilla Rise25 honoree is an amazing honor, especially given the group of people that are being recognized this year and the work that you're doing to make AI more inclusive and more equitable.